I'm ready to go in here and start making some changes. Once again, I'm going to follow the Adobe Camera Raw Smart Filter workflow and see if I can really affect that overall balanced change here first before doing anything in Photoshop. Once again, let's do our macro to micro changes. Just a small change in the temperature, I think, is fine overall, just to push everything in that direction of warmth. I'm not seeing any major differences in saturation here. Contrast looks consistent. Once again, these have already been retouched. But I think overall, we're going to drop the exposure a bit. Because in these images, the color is really dependent on the exposure. It's going to be different. You could have the same exact palette, these two images. If they have dramatically different exposures, that color is going to look quite a bit different. Now, just because I'm dropping the exposure image-wide doesn't mean I can't make a bit of a targeted adjustment in order to bring some focus back to the center of the image. So I'm using the adjustment brush, which I actually want to zero out. Click Reset Local Correction Settings. That's going to zero it out. And I just want to crank the exposure back up in here. Now, in Photoshop, moves like this are counterproductive. It's what I usually refer to as cross-curving. But in Camera Raw, we have so much information to work with, and it's really a light touch that we're able to make opposing adjustments and not destroy the image. And I'm going to brighten it up just a bit more. Hit Enter to exit, and H to return to the hand tool and all of our controls for Camera Raw. Next, I'm going to follow the steps and move into split toning. Now, remember that those shadows were all warm. They were in the red zone. Now, this is pretty dramatic, but it helps me to see, once I used a balance slider, how I'm compressing the tonal range that the split tone is applied to. And then I can bring that back down to a reasonable level. I'm not even going to mess with the highlights. I'm going to keep those where they are. Now I'm going to move into my HSL adjustments. The sort of wild card hue in this image looks to be the blues. I don't really see any blues in our target, so eliminating those will get us a little bit closer to a good family. Maybe I can shift these blues into a warmer hue. They're going purple. And it doesn't really look like it's able to push them that far around the color wheel. So in that case, I'm just going to see if I can desaturate those. I think that's an improvement right there. It gets them out of the way. I'm going to take a look at the yellows and see if I can push those a little bit warmer, because here they're still a bit pale. I don't know if it's going to be able to grab them or not, but yeah, I like that move, definitely. You can most see that move in the bottles here. We've got some greens in here that are close enough to these two very different greens to talk to each other. I'm going to click OK. Do a little before and after. That's a pretty dramatic quick change just using ACR. This is pretty close with minimal effort, but now that I'm seeing them side by side, I know I want to make a couple more tweaks. I'm going to go back into Camera Raw, and I think I can just open up this bottle a bit with a couple more targeted adjustments. Now, I kind of broke my rules of working in a targeted way in the RAW, but that's fine because these targeted adjustments are also completely editable forever. We can delete them if we need to. And that really heroes the bottle out. Okay, so I think I might dial that back just a little bit. And it's useful too to see how I can go in there and edit those targeted adjustments that I made. So I'm gonna peel that back just a little bit. Running a little hot. So that's a pretty clean grade on an already graded image. You see how quickly that works, how easily I'm able to make those adjustments. We started with an image that was our target, and we're able to extract all that information about the color, some pretty critical information about what color the darks were. And then through comparing the two color wheels with that little screen grab overlay trick I showed you, that is another tool in the toolbox to help you compare the two color situations that you're seeing. That's a great look at something that I have to deal with all the time. I'm having to pair two images together to family them. Clients are constantly asking me to create similarities between two different images for whatever use they need. So I was able to use our new color CC tricks in order to analyze the color that's in my target image. I'm able to use really quick methods with Camera Raw in order to affect the change and not destroy any information in the image.